Unfortunately, the homeless rate in Smithtown is larger than any of us would expect.
If I was talking to my younger self, telling myself that I went to college, I have a job, and I'm working full time, working 9 to 5, I wouldn't believe it.
Deidre would stop in my office probably once or twice a week, and sometimes she would tell me of the difficulties living with her grandmother. At that time, I did not realize that Deidre had slept in a park.
Leaving my grandma's house was probably my breaking point. To walk out the door and not know if I had clothes for the next day, not knowing if I had my backpack, not knowing if I had a cell phone, not knowing if I had any money. It was a tough choice being on your own at almost 18. I did find a park that I grew up in that's very familiar to me. I did spend the night there. Emotionally and mentally, I had to numb myself to be able to just handle it and cope. If I could tell myself anything in that moment is that it gets better, it wouldn't be that hard.
My first and foremost job is as a mother, and seeing the heartbreak that she was going through upset me greatly. It takes a village to raise a child, and Smithtown is an amazing community. And I felt at that point it was important for all of us to step up.
Mary Pat contacted me and said, I have a student. She wanted to become an emancipated minor, and we knew that she would need a lot of help. She would need the love, guidance, and support of, if not her family, then other people.
During her senior year, Deidre came to me and said, I want to go to college, but I don't know how to do that. We knew she would have to get there on a daily basis. Immediately, I thought of the Smithtown Children's Foundation because they've been such a wonderful resource within our community. And Christine Fitzgerald called me immediately and she said, okay, let's look into this a little bit further, but does she know how to drive?
To get to work, to get to college, she needed to know how to drive. We later got her driving lessons and bought a used car for her so she could work after school and go to college and same dreams other, you know, teenagers have.
Getting a car and getting my license, I was really handed the keys of my future. And now I'm working full-time in the city. I'm kind of figuring out what I want to do for the rest of my life and what kind of adult I want to be.
Really a rewarding experience. She graduated college, she's a graphic artist, and she donates her time and talent to the foundation, which all you can ask is if you help somebody, you hope they pay it forward, and Deidre has done that in spades.
The Smithtown Children's Foundation is without a doubt one of the best resources for families and children in need here in Smithtown. As soon as you mention the need of somebody, they are there to say, how can we help?
Initially, we were just three local moms who wanted to help a family whose daughter had a cancer diagnosis. As we pooled our resources running events for the Rivers family, we realized we were building something that could help the entire community. To date, we've raised about $750,000 that we use to help families in crisis pay medical bills, auto bills, household bills, etc. Well, unfortunately, there are other people like Deidre in the community, and I don't think people realize it. We're all guilty of it. We look through the world with our rose-tinted glasses on. I think the foundation has become a resource in the community. When people see, oh, my neighbor's sick, does the Smithtown Children's Foundation know? We're their first call.
There is an extreme need to help students, and Smithtown Children's Foundation does bridge the gap. And if you're a donor and you do have the means to help, I would definitely help a cause that can spread this far. Because if it wasn't for the kindness of strangers, my life would have turned out very differently than it did.
The road ahead, it twists and turns, and the sun beats down and it burns. But I keep on pushing through. And every step quicker than the last, my feet tread down this beaten path, and I keep on pushing through. 'Cause I get up and I may fall right back down. But you